A man shall be presumed to be the natural father of a child if he and the child's natural mother are or have been married to each other and the child is born during the marriage or within 300 days after the marriage is terminated by death, annulment, declaration of invalidity or dissolution, or after a decree of separation is entered by court. Who is my father? Marital presumption is usually to protect parents and children, and also the sanctity of marriage by assuming the husband and wife have both remained true to their marriage vow. Until recently, it was the only practical way to deal with the issue of paternity. But however, the advent of genetic testing like DNA has changed all of that, and questions are now being raised whether DNA should always be used in establishing the paternity of children born during subsistence of marriage. The Nigerian famous musician Davido has even added his voice and suggested his usage before child dedication. After all, some churches insist on pregnancy tests before marriage. So what are your own thoughts? In Pictures and Pictures, the Rhode Island Supreme Court was faced with a situation in which a man had known all along that he was not the biological father of his wife's child. Nonetheless, he raised the child as his own, assuring the mother that he would always care for the child. However, when the couple divorced, the husband tried to de-establish his paternity. In resisting his effort to do so, the court noted, as deep as our concerns are for the husband, we cannot sanction the proposition that children can be embraced and raised by a person as a parent and then discarded when the parent no longer gets along. Children are not mere personal property to be assigned or distributed upon divorce. The relationship of father and child is too sacred to be thrown off like an old cloak, used and unwanted. However, on the contrary, in Russell and Russell, citing Klemwager and Klemwager, the Indiana Supreme Court was faced with a similar situation to that faced by the Pictures Court. But however, the court allowed paternity de-establishment to proceed. But in Nigeria, the court have still held on to the presumption of the fact that the husband is the natural father of a child born during the subsistence of a marriage, or at least 300 days after separation. Even some tradition, until you pay the bride price of a child, of a mother, you cannot claim to be the father of the child. It is that man who paid the bride price that is said to be the father of that child. The Court of Appeal of Nigeria in Tonia Anozie versus Patricia Okwanwa Nani and another expressed thoughts. It is unimaginable for a court to order a senior citizen to submit himself to a DNA test in defiance of his fundamental right to privacy for the purpose of extracting scientific evidence to assist a father to confirm or disprove his wish that a man is his child of an illicit amorous relationship. The court was persuaded by the position of the Court of Appeal in Anode and Mmeka, where the court reemphasized that all children are lawful and legitimate, the circumstances of their birth notwithstanding, and that the right to a legitimate status must be viewed from the child's perspective, as there is no child without a biological father. Against that backdrop, I would therefore advocate that DNA should be a personal issue between husband and wife, who should be at liberty to determine whether they want to establish the paternity of their kids using DNA tests or through their trust for each other, and the sanctity of the institution of their union. After all, it takes more than two balls and a dick to father a child. The religious body or society should not browbeat anyone into going for a DNA test you are not psychologically ready for. Macho man, no dey the matter. And some people actually never recover from it. Though in some cases, the men might even have the premonition of their spouse's infidelity, they're usually silent on it, either because of societal concern or the largesse from such amorous relationship. Lastly, communication is very key in every marital relationship. And if you can laugh at it, you can live with it. Not everyone might agree with me though, but this is my position. So what is yours?